We have a female patient aged 12 years. Her condition started when he awoke with frequent attacks of diarrhea. It was semi-form, 2 to 3 emotions per day, associated with blood and mucus. History of diffuse dull aching abdominal pain and weight loss from 35 to 30 kilograms. There were no previous history of bleeding from any other orifices, no history of fever or vomiting, and she sought medical advice and was diagnosed as a case of gastroenteritis and was received successive metronidazole courses. On examination, the patient was active and having normal vital signs. She had mild abdominal distension without organomegaly or lymphadenopathy, and other system examinations were unremarkable. Her initial workup revealed there was an increased ESR 50 over 65 and hemoglobin 10.7, and also the platelet count was 553. Stone analysis showed blood cells from 10 to 15 and RBCs from 5 to 10, with other initial labs unremarkable. Subsequently, she was referred for an endoscopic evaluation where we did an upper endoscopy and it revealed mild distal esophagitis and mildly inflamed mucosa of the duodenum. The lower endoscopy of the lesion of the rectosigmoid was done and revealed severely inflamed fibrous mucosa of the examined segment, which bleeds in touch and where multiple biopsies taken. The patient then started high dose of 5-aminosalicylic acid as a result of the biopsies. 15 days later, she presented to the ER with subsuspicious high-grade fever, bilious vomiting, and absolute constipation. Upon examination, there was a tender rigid abdomen together with a large paravaginal abscess. Her erectile abdominal X-ray showed in under the diaphragm. Emergent surgical exploration was performed where we found 2 sub-sigmoid colon perforation, along with myogenic membranes involving the whole intestine with perineal pelvic connection. Elostomy and mucous fistula were done, and the abscess was drained and cultured. Her condition improved, but slightly post-operative status, and the proper antibiotic-based on culture were initiated. However, the patient developed a perianal fistula, for which we ordered an MRI for stenography, and the results of the previously taken biopsies now revealed. The rectosigmoid biopsy showed surface ulceration with erosions and distorted crypt, also with cryptitis and cryptabscesses. The duodenal mucosa showed increased intra epithelial lymphocytes more than 30, together with mild mononuclear inflammatory cells and eosinophilia. We have now chronic proctosegmentitis with marked activity, together with marked duodenitis with preserved villi and lymphocytosis. The MRI fistulography showed left paravaginal fistula measuring about 3.5 centimeters. And the CT enterography was ordered that showed moderate circumferential mural thickening of the rectum sigmoid and descending the colon, along with increased mural enhancement associated with diffuse edematous mesorectal fascia and regional lymphadenopathy. While the small bowel was with normal uniform wall thickening, and these findings were suggestive of inflammatory bowel disease.
Assalamu alaikum jamian. To summarize our case, احنا عندنا female patient, 12 years old patient with chronic blood in her ear, with history of large paravaginal abscess. The colonoscopy reveals inflamed mucosa of the rectosigmoid and pathology can be by ان احنا عندنا proctosigmoiditis with marked activity. و CT angiography كان مبين ان احنا عندنا circumferential thickening of the rectum and sigmoid with descending colon. وال MRI عندنا في فيسكل. What do you think about this case? Should we start with conventional therapy as 5-aminosalicylic acid, or start with immunomodulator, or steroids, or de novo biological therapy? Okay. Flow chart اللي جاي دوت هيبين لنا المانجمنت اوف بيدياتريك كرونز ديزيز. يعني بيعتمد ميني على الستبس اللي بتحصل او الستيجز بتاعت الكرونز ديزيز. لو عندنا اكتف كرونز ديزيز نون بريانال ديزيز بنشوف الاسس بنأسس الريسك اوف بور اوتكم. لو احنا عندنا low inflammatory markers او عندنا non structure او non penetrating وبنassess growth. لو ما عندناش failure of growth وعندنا low risk of poor outcome بنعمل induction بال exclusive enteral feeding او nutrition او بالcorticosteroid. وبنستنى ونعمل evaluation بعد كده عشان نشوف treatment target reached after 12 weeks. لو already وصلنا لتريتمنت تارجت سواء كلينيكال او باثولوجيكال العيان بنمشي عليها على المينتنس بتاعنا سواء بالميثوتريكسيد او ممكن نقعد ميثوتريكسيد او ثايوبرين او المينتنس انترال نيوتريشن. لو ما عندناش وما وصلناش للتارجت بتاعنا افتر 12 ويكس الحقيقه هنا الاندكشن بيخلينا لازم نشيفت على الانتي تيومر جروث ثيرابي ونكونسيدر كومبينيشن ويز ميونوموديليتور عشان نقلل الاميونوجينيسيتي. طب لو من الاول عندنا سيفير جروث فيلير او التارجت بتاعنا ما وصلش افتر 12 ويكس هنا برضو بنستنى الاندكشن اوف انتي تيومر جروث ثيرابي ونكونسيدر كومبينيشن ويز ميونوموديليتور. طب برضو لو احنا عملنا اسسمنت اوف بور عشان نشوف الاسسمنت اوف ريسك اوف بور اوتكم لو كان هاي بمعنى ان احنا عندنا extensive disease او deep colonic ulcers او strictures بس without P stenotic dilatation هنا برضو هيبقى عندنا المانجمنت بتاعنا هيبتدي الاندكشن بالانتي تيومر جروث ثيرابي ونكونسيدر كومبينيشن ويز اميون موديليتور. بنوصل للتريتمنت بار بتاعنا بعد الاندكشن ولو وصلنا له اوكي بنمشي المانتنس بتاعنا every 8 weeks وبنقعد as a monotherapy او with methotrexate or thiopurine. طب لو ما وصلناش للتريتمنت تارجت بتاعنا بنعمل اوبتمايزيشن للانتي تيومر ثيرابي وبنجر الانتي تيومر نيكروزيس فاكتور تروفلا. لو احنا استخدمنا الانتي تيومر نيكروزيس فاكتور بالرغم من كده احنا لسه الاكتيفيتي بتاعتنا موجوده في الكرونز ديزيز بنعمل التروف ليفل ميجرمنت ولو لقينا تو لو الحقيقه بنشوف التتر اوف ذا انتي بودز. لو لقينا الانتي بودي تتر بتاعنا عندنا موجود يبقى احنا عندنا immunogenic loss of response. بتشوف التتر بتاعنا لو very high الحقيقه هنا لازم نعمل switch from infliximab to adalimumab. لكن لو عندنا low anti drug anti touch بنعمل escalation يا اما بنزود الdose بتاعتنا او بنعمل doubling للdose او بنزود immunomodulator. طب لو ما عندناش antibody وبالرغم من كده ان العيان ما بيتحسنش يبقى احنا عندنا pharmacokinetic loss of response وساعتها برضه بنعمل escalation سواء بنزود الدوز او بنزود الاميون ميديريتور. طب لو التروف ليفل بتاعنا كان in range وبالنسبه للانفليكسيماب بيبقى around 5 microgram per milliliter يبقى احنا عندنا pharmacokinetic loss of response.